Hello and welcome back to Total War Attila, Age of Charlemagne. This is the Battle of Chartres, the battle that you saw last episode. Apparently I forgot to save after the battle, so we had to do it again. At the moment, it looked like I was winning. The enemy only has an Onaga crew left and I have my Sieg spent. But for some reason, my men are underpowered. Which makes no sense because we do outnumber the enemy. But apparently the game sees it like that. Anyway, I already did like 5 minutes of this, but then I accidentally stopped the recording, and at the moment I can't easily edit them together, so I just started a new recording. But anyway, so the reason behind that, behind the lack of videos for the past couple days, is that my internet provider just had problems, and I had no internet for a couple of days, which, to be honest, it's probably more annoying for me than for you, but that's the reason why I couldn't upload, because, well, I just didn't. I just couldn't. There was no internet, so no possibility for me to upload. And thus, I haven't really recorded anything, of course. I mean, I could have recorded in advance, but I don't like that. I like to record daily for reasons. Anyway, yeah, I hope you... I'm not apologizing for that, because it's not in my power. It's just, it's not my fault. Draw. Okay, so we did not win, but at least we drawed this time. I don't know what I did differently this time, but we did better, apparently. I did exactly the same as last time, but apparently it was better. Not sure how that worked out. But yeah, we won. Chartres is safe. We're gonna slaughter all the enemies. Actually, let's take them on. For our garrison force here. Well, that's sad, because now I have to do everything again that I did in the turn. But not too problematic, because I don't think I did too much in it. But yeah, I just forgot to save. Mistakes happen. Apparently, even to me. Okay, so let's see. I haven't played in, well, a couple of days, as you might have expect. A worthy bride. Notguth wants to marry Vithin. She's political. Is Vithin a character of mine? Probably. I'm gonna give him my blessing. Oh, is Vithin? No, Vithin is a character of mine. That's not Vithin. That's a that Vithin. There's a living Vithin. And his wife, Nofguth. This guy needs a wife as well. By the way, this guy needs an office as well. But we don't have one. But you can get an office. You're a governor. Loyalty. Well, yeah, become a noble. You need a wife, but you don't have the power for that. And the rest of you can just become retainers at the moment. What? You're the same person? Excuse me, what? Oh, okay, I see. I understand. She is the daughter of Vithin, and he is the bastard son of Vithin. What? Are these two different... What? Okay, so this guy is what? 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 Can someone explain this to me? Okay, so he's this guy. He has two daughters. One of them already died, Ethelberg. Wow, that's a... Well, anyway, and the other one is Adbirth. Adbirth is married to Leovine. Leovine is his bastard son? Or is it Elred's bastard son? But what is he doing over here? Oh, no, okay, I understand now. He's the father of this girl, that's why he's over here as well. but Leovine is the bastard son of Elred. For a moment I thought we had some kind of incest going on over here, but luckily not. Wanna keep the genes clean here over in Saxony. Anyway, what a confusing situation. Where's this army that we saw up north now? In Chartrey. Where is Chartrey? Chartrey. Must be somewhere north here. There it is. The enemy army is still standing in front of it. Hopefully we cannot catch up with them. We can't, but we are still going in their direction, this army. Even though I don't think they are that much of a threat anymore after we've beaten them. Then we have this army that is going to take Genève with an automatic battle. Ah, lost my dogs. Liberate the Duchy of Burgundy. No, I'm not gonna occupy it, of course. I might liberate some Italians down there. Don't mind that. What did I want to build here? Probably a blacksmith. So get rid of that mine and give me not a priory, but a sacred ground over here. Let's repair Chartrey because we had no towers, I remember, because the settlement was still destroyed. No, it wasn't. Why did we not have towers here then? I don't understand. I mean, the watermill apparently is... Oh, the settlement is still under siege, huh? Oh, if I only had known that earlier. Well, we're gonna repair everything in Chartrey. If I had known that earlier, then I could have attacked them or something. Well, I don't think they would have run if we attacked them without the army nearby. So maybe it's the best how it happened in the end. Okay, so that's my money. It's gone. Siena is under our control but needs to be turned into a sacred ground. That's more of my money gone. Pisa is... We need to change a lot over here. First of all, repair everything. Actually, the horse show can be destroyed. The forge can be destroyed and the gallery can be destroyed as well. Well, you know, the gallery is not bad. I might keep that. That's not bad. Corruption value of adjacent provinces in Pavia. But then again, it matters not, so let's get rid of it. But what am I going to build on it? Why am I repairing this? Let's get rid of this as well. Let's keep it for now. I mean, 5%, that's not bad. And to public order. I like it. We're gonna keep it. This army is going to take Spoleto. Yes, lay siege to their hovels. Conquer it quickly. Send over the spy to Rome. That's the last province down south that we need to take from the Duchy of Provence. We have the Duchy of Benevento riding around here as well. I thought I heard someone at my door, but it could be possible. I mean, it's late and already, so I assume everybody else sleeps, but you know, ghosts never sleep at this time, I guess. Maybe I shouldn't scare myself because I'm easily scared, especially of ghosts and shit. I don't believe in that stuff, but I don't think we should mess with something we can't understand. Or we as long as you can't. I don't know if I should even go there. I don't think I should go in that direction. I'm still thinking about talking about it, but I don't think it's a good idea. Okay, we have a battle down here. Marseille is also under our control, which needs to be changed. We could go over to Nice. conquer it, but then Marseille would be alone, and this army could take it. The Lights of Absolution. Okay, so what? The Provence has not much left. Only these three provinces and Rome. And Rome is going to fall very soonish. So I think the last forces are in Arles and Genova. And that's very good, because that's where my forces are also located. We have this army up north, which can take out the last of the Alemannian force. But then again, I don't see a reason to provoke, not provoke them, but to attack them just because. Oh, I totally forgot this force. What am I going to do with this one? Oh yeah, I wanted to attack this with this army. Sadly, they've run. Well, now that they have run, I should probably attack them with this force. I don't really feel like fighting them, to be honest. How's Pavia doing? Pavia's not doing well when it when it comes to a garrison force. Excuse me. Soon we can march against the Duchy of Benevento and everything that is down south, like the Duchy of Sicily. The theme of Sicily, I mean, of course. Sicily is Byzantine, isn't it? This theme. It is a Byzantine duchy. You know, a theme. Do they have Byzantine units then? Would be interesting. Okay, well, I guess we have to attack one or the other. Either we go for Genova or we go north and take out this army. And it's probably for the best to take out this army. And I'm going to send my melee heavy army against them. Of course, I could just automatically do that, but I don't feel like it. I don't really want to control a large army either. He has no cavalry. The skirmishers, of course, could kill a lot of my men. Let's just do it. No need to waste any time. By the way, if you hear a noise that sounds like a fan, then... Oh, that's a river crossing. Interesting. Well, then that's my fan, because it's really, really warm. And the fan is not actually for me, but it's for my PC, because the built-in fans are not good enough. Not for this weather. So without the additional fan outside, my PC would just overheat, and that's not good. Especially not while recording, as you might imagine. Excuse me, where's the crossing? Over there, okay. Well, this makes everything a little bit different. I wish I have attacked with the other army now, because this army has no archers. And archers are very, very important in the crossing. Is it just me and does this map look like a little bit dead? I mean, not only can we look at underneath, but looks a little bit okay. Don't know why that is. Well, we're just gonna position our spears up. Actually, I think my swords are a better unit to blockade the river. So you are going first in. I want you in the back and my axe on the flanks. I might actually let them cross a little bit so I can flank them around a little bit better. Especially with my javelins. Might be an idea. Get my cavalryman as well on the flanks, and at the back, of course, my general. As he is a good general, commanding his units far, far away from the actual slaughter. We're just gonna keep our honor guards on the sides here. Probably aiming at the enemy honor guards as soon as they can. Like, just fire at these middle ones. I want you to spread out a little bit. Get you on the flanks. I don't expect him to attack me, in all honesty. Because it is me who attacks him, after all. Can he actually throw over this? I hope not. What's going on? Oh, we already destroyed some of his onagas. That's very good. Hopefully we continue with doing that. Let's get some of my spears on the flanks as well. His archers are of course aiming at my javelins, but it is just how it is going to be for now. Are my onagas actually firing? I don't see any of them fire. I know you can do it. Please do it. Come on. It seems like he's... I'm not sure if he's going to cross or not. Well, my onagas are certainly aiming at his onagas. That's good. Still not sure if he's going to cross. No, I don't think he's going to cross. What can I do to get him closer? Maybe send forth two of my javelins? Okay, that's good. More Onaga crews taken out. You fire at this one and you will fire at this one now. You get a little bit further spread out and you want to throw at the enemy over there on the other side. Good, good, good. More onagas taken out before they can fire at me. He seems very very angry now. So maybe I should retreat my javelins. And that a little bit quicker. So onagas are retreating as well. Good. At least we are hitting a couple of other units from them. Ooh, my javelins are doing a good job. I think we need to send our axes in now. Maybe we wait. Okay, no, don't wait any longer. We retreat a little bit. Send in the swordsmen as well. Most of his forces are never even gonna see my javelin men. Like, they're gonna die before they reach them. Oh, he's firing back at me now. But I think I should maybe focus my fire now into this big blob. Or you still fire at this onaga that's firing at me. And my swordsmen are just going to crush through them here. Get my cavalry in there to take out these skirmishers. Yeah, this battle is going to be over quickly. I don't expect them to. I think we are going to. We are taking a little bit too much friendly fire on this side over here. Send in the cav. Now take out the javelins of his. This looks very good. Ooh, yeah, very, very close to be honest, but still good enough. Apparently, we just killed the crew over here. Yep, there they are. Burning in hell. Well, burning on earth, but soon burning in hell as well. This looks very nice. Look at this blood. Look at all these javelins. Sadly, a lot of my axemen got javelins in their bags, but that's just, you know. Ooh, that's not good. Lots of my cavalrymen are getting killed here by his javies. I don't like that. I thought maybe we could get them all at once so they can't really do much against me, but no. It seems like they got some good volleys against me. We are now firing at his general, who is standing in the midst of his units, so... If we can kill his general here, the battle is over. I mean, the battle is over anyway, but it would be quicker over if we kill his general. I don't like losing my cavalry like this, but it happened. It already happened, so... Nothing I can do against that anymore. The bad thing about that is that all his javelins are still free to do whatever they want now. I'm going to retreat my swordsman here. Reinforcements? No, okay. Oh, that means that my unit got completely destroyed here. That's a shame. Well, let's try to kill his general with our javies. Throw. Throw. Come on. A little bit too late. Oh, we do have a spear unit just nearby. Oh, well, he's dead. That should crush his morale. Fire now at these javelies. As well as our javies. Yeah, I think that's it for his morale. He might retreat again, because the AI likes to cheat. I have nothing to run them down with, because I sacrificed my cavalry. Well, I didn't really sacrifice them, I just sent them in too early. Should have waited a little bit longer. Now they're all dead. I don't know, but cavalry seems to die off far more often than infantry or skirmishes for me. And yeah, of course he could retreat again, but that's not gonna save him in the end. And there he goes. I'm not sure how that was a river crossing anyway. Well, this army kind of needs to move back here now to get more horsemen. I can't even afford riders at the moment, so let's just go back into Pavia. And he will go somewhere down here, maybe lay an ambush. I like ambushes, so let's lay one. Good. Are there any other forces that I have to move? No. The bonus save, this army up here just conquered Geneve, so it can't move at the moment. This force up here is still occupied. Yeah, I think it's time to end the turn. But before we do that, of course, we have to give our troops some skills here. Synagif and the other dude that I forgot the name of. Don't take it personally, General, because I have a very, very large empire, and to remember all the goddamn names of every single general I have, that's too much. Especially because all of you have the same name. Like, we have Synagif and Wolfref and other people that... Not a single one of those names is actually a name that they have. Sadly, the ambush did get discovered, which is very bad, because now they are in a bad spot. And I don't think they've retreated in a better spot here. No, they didn't. And now we have to face the elite army and the other army. This is bad. This is very bad. Oh, well, what am I going? I have to fight this. I have to fight this. His skirmishes, he doesn't have too many skirmishes, so that's good. And his infantry, his swordsmen are strong, but the rest is beatable. Let's save and then go into it. Well, it is, of course, it's foggy. I'm gonna keep a rather tight formation because I don't have that much infantry. I just hope that we don't get demolished here. His army was expensive, but it's... Let's be honest, it is replaceable. Even though that sounds really, really evil, if I say it like that. Oh, look, yeah, 2,500 men or something like that. We can't just sacrifice them. They're replaceable. Our army is exactly the same size. That's interesting. Oh, we do have archers. That's very good, though. Like, archers are an important tool, especially in Age of Charlemagne. I hope they are just as important in Warhammer. Even though I kind of don't expect that to be, because they do have gunners and stuff in Warhammer. The general probably has to get into the action as well this time. I know this formation looks a little bit like a noob box, but it's not a noob box. It's a tightly packed formation, okay? Okay, the enemy has reinforcements over there. We have no timer because we can't retreat. As you can see, there's no retreat button down here. We will go into shield formation, shield wall, as soon as they come close to us. But I just want them to be exhausted. And I don't want them to just fire at my swordsmen when in a very tightly packed formation like the shield wall. I mean, look at this. You can't really miss anyone, especially if you fire huge boulders into that. So that's... I don't want that yet. Just be in normal formation. I'm not sure if I want my onagers to just fire at whatever they want. Or if I'm going to concentrate my fire on anything. Let's send one of my cavalrymen to scout. I know what they're doing. They are forming up both of their armies to form one massive force. And that's not good for us, as you might expect. But there's nothing I can do to hinder them. I could have tried to assault the first army, but the second one would have intervened way too quickly. And I think that would have been a very, 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 very bad decision on my part. So, we're just gonna camp over here for now. See where the enemy is. Where the enemy is. There they are. Don't get into range of the onagers, please. Just scout their army. Am I wrong? Does he have no interest in attacking me whatsoever? Or maybe he's still forming up with the second army. Because this army, it looks big, but that's not 40 units. Not even close to it. I don't think the second army is yet here. Where is the second army? It's probably still in the woods over here. Go take a look, cavalry. That's what you are. Well, you're a Saxon cavalry, not a scout cavalry, but still. Okay, there's his cavalry, and there are his other forces. Okay. So he's forming up right now. He's actually very aggressively running towards my cavalry, and I don't like that. Just as they're just scouting, so please leave them alone. He's running his men everywhere, so hopefully he's exhausted when he's arriving at us. Let's move our army a little bit like that. Hopefully they should arrive there before the enemy comes into range. This does not look good for us, not gonna lie. That's a lot of enemies. There are a lot of enemies, and at least half of them are very elite soldiers, not just some peasant rebel. I mean, even these guys over here are somewhat trained. He does not have any levy units here, and it seems like he's trying to surround me. I don't like that either. Let's try to position our flank a little bit new. Move up the archers. Yes. Okay, he's coming. Get my cavalry over here. Cavalry will not do anything against those skirmisher cav units, sadly. Just get them over here. This cavalry certainly can charge in here. Please throw at them. Yes, kill them all. This is very bad so far. Not a good start. Is he charging me? He's not charging me. He's just dying over here. That's good. Okay, but my archers are now in a very bad spot. I don't like how that is going. I need to do something about the skirmishers up front. Because otherwise they're going to demolish my soldiers, my shield wall, before I even form it. And that's a lot of troops coming on my left flank here. So send over the other spearmen. Maybe send my... Yes. Excellent. My health cavalry did catch them. Ooh, what am I going to do with those guys? Also, there's a lot of units in the middle here. Form a shield wall now. Ooh, this is very bad. He's using his numbered advantage to just outflank me so hard. I can't do anything about that right now. I just have to do something. Use my cavalry wisely or something like that.
Our men flee the field of battle.
Who's running? One of my cavalry units is running. Well, that's really a shameful display. This unit over here. Well, actually, that's not a shameful display. They were surrounded a lot by a lot of enemies. Okay, I need to stop talking for a moment here because I actually need to concentrate or something like that. You know.
Enemy units have returned to the battle.
I don't think we're gonna win this battle. Let's be honest. Don't think we're gonna win this. No, they're not trying to take out our general. I send him in the battle. Dingle Donga. Get some armor piercing shots or something. Put him in the flanks. Actually, we are fighting them back somewhat, somehow. These noble javelin men, they are so good, even in melee. Look at that! They are beating this spearman unit in melee. That's quite impressive. That's a cavalry unit, a general unit. Get my cavalry down here. Yes, that's good. You're not taking out these armored spearmen as much as I would have liked, so please go a little bit closer. You also need to fire at them. Ooh. There's no charging my other unit. Actually, no. Yes. Good. Shut up me. Need to concentrate here. Not bad so far. Let's get those guys over here. Maybe you go down here.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
Don't be afraid, you cowards. We are winning. Stand and fight. We actually are winning.
No.
You fight those mercenary skirmishers, please. You're firing that, that's good. Man, that got them on agar. Yes. Come back. This is not good.
Our men are breaking off!
You're breaking off? Stop that. you spearmen, take out that general. Onaga, you target those skirmishers. One of my last cavalries, go over here, we need you in the back of the enemies real quick. Otherwise this is going down. Like, the skirmishers need to die before they just kill everything over here. Good, I think the archers are doing a fantastic job. They are. Try killing those guys. Here's my cavalry. My cavalry is doing whatever they can. We are beating back them on this side. I think we won. I think victory is ours. Stop firing. Victory is ours. Oh. Whew. That was a battle and a half, if I have to say so myself. We actually won. Just kill them now. Oh, we shouldn't praise the evening before the day, but I don't know if that is that even a saying in English. I know it's in German, but saying sometimes you can't really translate those things. But I think we won here, so it's fine to praise the battle already. Whew. That was apparently we still only have. Our power is still equal, or a little bit better than theirs now. But I think we won this gloriously. We lost good men today, but everyone fought to the end. Look at my general! 361 kills, and he lost 5 men. That, Osmond, you are brutal. You and your... What? Oh, the enemy is losing their advantage, yes. I was like, what? I'm losing my advantage? What kind of world do you live in, my friend? Why did we not get a... Whoa. Why is the battle still on? Oh, they still have their onagas. Right. Well, let's send down my cavalry. Down here, they still have their onagas running around back there. Okay, so my general was just a monster. My spearmen did well, they have hauled the flanks and protected us from any charges from the sides. My javelin men, they are incredible! They are so good in melee, it is illegal. You need to take out. My cavalry, the Hearth cavalry did not do that well, I mean they did good. But in comparison to my Saxon cavalry over here, that nearly lost nothing but killed 420 men. Blaze it every day. Anyway, maybe that's the secret why they are so good. But yeah, now they are gonna crush this Onaga crew as well. And after that, they're gonna crush the other Onaga crews. Just kill all the Onagas. Kill them all. That's 3, and over there is another one. Or 2. I don't care, just take them out before they fire at you, please. Good, good, good. What a battle! My swordsmen did a fantastic job at just holding the front. My archers did good. I mean, archers never kill too much, but these guys did their job very well. And my Onaga, well, okay, my Onaga did not do that good, but they didn't really have the prime target there. A close victory, you say? I say that's an heroic victory, all the way. I mean, look at the kills on my javelin, man. 380, 288, 370. They are, okay. The MVP is this Saxon cavalry, but the javelin men did so well. Without them, I would have lost probably. I mean, they've held the front, the flank so long, alone. Incredible. And look at that, only his skirmishers survived. They're actually going to take on some of those warriors. Let's slaughter everyone. I don't need your dirty bastards. They are weak. You outnumbered us twice to one. 2-1. And you still lost. What a weak performance of you, Duchy of Provence, even though you had one very elite army. I mean, they did well. Not gonna... We can't... Well, they didn't do well, but they tried their best. They outflanked me hard, so... I applaud them for that, I guess. That they just didn't charge me frontal with everything they had. They could've probably pushed through if they did that. But I'm content how the battle went, and... The Duchy of Alemania has been destroyed. Decree? Office secured, that's good. With this, I thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, then consider leaving a like and a comment down below. The Guardians of Irminsul, once again, proven their worth. They've lost something. They've lost one swordsman and one cavalryman. We can't just get the cavalry back, but that, not, no. As I said, I thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, then consider leaving a like and a comment down below. And we will see us in the next episode. Until then, take care. Bye.